Hello everyone, this is System Collapse, and I'm back yet again playing FTB Beyond. And I have done nothing between videos. Nothing. Literally nothing. Nothing at all. Let's not look at this. Let's go elsewhere. No, I'm just joking. I'm just joking. I did an insane amount between videos. Insane. I think I've spent about 50 like game days working on stuff. Yeah, mostly just working on this. It's nowhere near done. I still got tons to do. I can't wait until I have a second computer and I can time-lapse this stuff, but yeah, let's take a look here. I did a setup here. This is the same setup we did yesterday, just a little more clean. Ready to go. These are just activators. I got four of them set up. Kind of did like a pedestal setup with them. It works. Over here, same kind of setup, but there's no mixing. So here it's just, what do I have set up? I have gold, lead, and copper set up to go. None of it's turned on right now, mind you, and there's a reason for that, but we're going to get to that in a bit. Over here is going to be where we're going to do the altar. There's an alchemy altar in this mod, and we're going to be doing that over. Well, it's going to get set up over here. We're going to build it over here today, but in time, this will be just a path linking up to that path. So that's what we're going to do there. These, you might think, oh, he just put blocks down or walls or something. This is actually a multi-block, and I'm not going to use these. I was going to use it at first. Where is it? The reservoir and the ring. Do I have no more rings? Oh, yeah. I should have a bunch more because I made like 40 because I thought I was going to use them. This is a multi-block. Where's a good place to do this? I could just do it here. Multi-block. Tank. Liquid tank. Oops. Don't want to do that. And I was going to use it. I might use it around the altar. Do, you know, just for aesthetics. I might do one with like lava maybe or something like that. Maybe copper. But not much use. Not much use for me in this mod. Nothing really needs water or lava. So I don't know what will tank. I mean, I could tank massive amounts of copper. But what's the point when I could just, you know, turn it into ingots. But it is cool. Little multi-block. It's got the same bottom. You can wire things out, add the mechanical cores and that jazz. So instead, I just use the chemite rings, which are actually really cheap. These are really cheap. As aesthetic blocks. And I'm going to be using these relays that are up here. And there's going to be a centerpiece in the middle. But we're going to get to that. We're going to get to that. These are all pretty much just aesthetics at this point. They are going to get used for things. Yeah, I've done a few things. Also, yeah, I did stuff down here. Whoops. This here, too, might look like it's clear. It's actually window frames from Architecture Craft. I like that little ridge. Don't ask me why. I just like the little ridge. So I made a ridge. You can see here there's relays going all the way down. This item pipe here, totally aesthetic. It's just all lead, so I don't really care. Snaking it down. These are the Ember Lanterns. So the Ember Lantern. Let's just go to Lantern. Should be able to find it here pretty quick. Ember Lantern. So yeah, just iron plate, and Ember Shard. And they're just nice little animated lamps. Just thought I'd put those in there. Down here, this is drained. So there, it is definitely finite of how much Ember is in each chunk. But yeah. It's so this is dead. All the other ones are dead. I have stuff going on down here too. I used a builder to clear out a massive area down here so I can move around boars very easily. I've already done 1, 2, 3, 4 sets of 12 to get a whole bunch of shards. Also, here, is this done? Is this done? It's done. How much lava is in that? Oh, that one's empty. 7 million lava. Nice. And I can see a lot of that lava isn't going to go away because it wasn't block updated, which kind of sucks, but we'll deal with that. I just wanted to get rid of the lava and the liquids, so I was just filtering it out. You just use one drum with the shape card, clearing pump, and use one of these. Let the first liquid fill into this, then wait till this one gets clogged up. Then you can switch it over the water. It automatically filters itself. You don't have to worry about it after that point. So you just, yeah, ender tank it over. And of course, I got speeds in there. But, yeah, so these ones I think are dead right now. No, they're not dead. These ones are still going because the thing is full. I haven't drained it. I actually didn't do these ones too long ago. But I've done three more down that way. Kind of keeping track, trying to do it in an organized way. I don't need a ton. I'm only going to do so much with this mod, but I want to get it all set up. Let's see here. What else? What else? Oh, I'm going to show you something cool and amazing. Cool and amazing. And this is my sensitivities up. I updated. And this is going to drive me crazy because I always play in this. Where's controls? I need to turn that down to 50. You guys think I'm a spastic the way I move when I have my sensitivity up, so I usually turn it down. I play too many FPS games, first-person shooters, and you're always moving. Always moving. let me see here. So if I turn this on, this is mostly just for aesthetics, mind you, but this is why I love this mod. Just look at this. Look at it. Look at it. It's amazing. It's amazing. Just spiraling all around. It doesn't, there might be a limit to how many relays you can put them through, but I haven't found it yet. I have not found it. And this is just temporary, but these are even going to go up further. But I'm going to come down here and turn that off. And just watch them spiral up. So, you know, as this is going, I'll be able to, you know, if you ever look down here, bam, this will be coming up. Which is pretty cool. Pretty cool. Pretty awesome. I love this mod. This is quickly becoming my favorite. I guess it's an early game mod. So this would be my favorite early game mod. And it is really amazing. I mean, the quality of this mod and the work that the dev did on this mod. It is something special. Something special. And I haven't run into many bugs yet. I think the only real bug I have so far is with this thing, the mixing centrifuge. If I want to make Dawnstone, sometimes if I connect it to the bottom, it'll make the Dawnstone. Sometimes if I connect it to the top, it'll make Dawnstone, but it won't other times. Right now, it was working connected to the bottom, so I'm sticking with it. It just, this is a little, you can see here, there's an air top add-on, you know, base. But this tooltip, but there's something going on there, and I don't understand exactly what's going on, because it'll work most of the time, that all of a sudden, doesn't matter if I put in equal amounts of copper and gold, all of a sudden I'll have just copper in here, or just gold. So, I did make a ton of Dawnstone though, so I'm able to make all that stuff. So, we are going to make some things today, so let's get to it. Well, I already made most of it, go over the recipes. I don't even know why I'm going over the recipes, they're super cheap. The first thing I want to do though, where is it? There we go. We're going to do the crystal cell. Crystal cell. This is very important to me. This thing is basically a giant battery. This thing is a giant battery, and it's upgradable. You can't see how much the kit contains by default. Let's see if we can with an ember gauge. Here. We'll do it now. No. We'll have to wait till it's set up. Whoa. Let's take off the 3x3. Yeah, we're going to get this set up. I don't know how high I'm going to go. Just need to find the center point. That is the center. Kind of what I had planned out. Now, hurry up and do your boom. It's coming. It's gonna come. We're gonna hear a boom. There we go. Bye, rain. Anyway, I love that thing. Celestial manipulator is a amazing thing. And I was thinking I'd put this, you know, somewhere up here. It doesn't really matter what height. I just kind of wanted it as... I'm falling. It's okay. We're okay. Somewhere up here. Looks cool. Maybe... Is that too high? Nah, that'll work. That'll work. And we'll just break all this. Get rid of this. And like I said, this is an upgradable battery. So before we do anything, we're actually going to upgrade it. So we're going to get to that. Oh, something else I want to show you before I even do that. Let's take a look here. This. It looks like a wall. It's not. If you look at the top there, it says sneaky lever. So I can actually turn on and off the ember with hidden levers. So this doesn't have a connection right now, but if I did make one, so if I went, whoops, wrong. Let's go over here. Here. And here. And there you go. There you go. And I can turn it off. Just a good way to hide levers. Levers, however you want to pronounce it. I'm not going to judge anyone. But that's what I did there. And the sneaky lever is pretty cheap. Let's see here. I think it was just wither dust and something else. Where is it? Sneaky leather. Levers. Recipe. So the sneaky block, you're going to make sneaky block. Any kind of stone. Dwindle cream, which is slime and a wither dust. There you go. pretty sweet, very useful. And we're just gonna go over here. We'll throw in our mechanical core just to extend the connection. Some of these accessors, again, just to extends the connection again, makes it look a little better, and gives kind of some aesthetics at the same time. We're gonna need, we need to pump into it, so we need, I guess, just a pipe, item pump. Oh, that'll work anyway, won't matter. And maybe a chest. And I do want to get an ember gauge. I do have one. There we go. So I should be able to throw that maybe here. There we go. I guess the base amount it can hold is 64,000 ember, which is pretty cool. But I'm pretty sure it could upgrade to 144,000, I think. So let's see here. Do I have any embers in here? Embers? No. Okay. Well, we're just going to grab a couple stack of the lesser ones right now. And we can upgrade this more later on. But for right now, we see we got more embers coming in because they're backlogged and those machines are still running down there. Throw those there. And we should just need a lever. Let's see how far this takes us. There we go. And you can see the laser thing starts doing and the crystal starts growing. So that is the main thing I'm going for. I want the large crystal just so it looks a lot cooler. I think it's a little bigger than that, or is that, no, maybe, little? It only gets so big, then it stops. Oh, it gets pretty big. How big is that? Oh, I am wasting ember. Oh, after it reaches max size, which is 144,000, you just waste the ember. So I just wasted probably about a stack of ember, but it's just the shards anyway, or the crystals, but yeah, there we go. We have a giant battery. This will pull in all the ember that we want, you know, pulled in. And this will let us send it different places, which is pretty cool. Pretty cool. And now, if I go to here, I'm actually curious about something. And I've been curious for a while. If I can multiple connection this. It's something I kind of wanted to do. I haven't tried it yet. Oops, that was wrong. Let's do this. Then that. And that. Now, let's see if these all fire into that. That one's going to go up. That one. Oh, it does work. That is beautiful. Look at that. Oh, one's not working. Is this one off? I did something wrong here, but that's an easy fix. There we go. And just... And is that on or off? There we go. There we go. Look at that. That is amazing. Then I could use these to send power to different parts of the base. But I'm going to turn these off right now. And we're going to get on the other stuff. When this thing is fully going and this thing becomes a light show, it's going to be amazing. We're going to work on, where is it? Hearth coil. And I actually want to use this anyway. So this is basically a giant oven. I'm going to need more placement blocks just so I can access the bottom. I'm not sure where this is going to go. It's probably going to go over by the altar because I'm, like I said, it's going to be like three armed. So, and then a path coming out. That is the plan for this build. Let's do this and maybe that. There we go. And we'll just get rid of these. And I actually have a really good use for this, and I'm probably going to use it for a fairly long time because we still have an insane amount of draconium. I have 7.8 million draconium dust, and this thing is a giant oven. This is the sole purpose of this thing. That's all it does in life. It cooks things. It's a giant smelter, basically. And I want to use it. So for right now, I'm only going to use one and one, I guess, because I really don't need more. This and this. And it uses ember to smell things, obviously. So I'm going to do that and this and maybe a receptor. And it, the way it works is it kind of heats up over time. And the quicker, the more it heats up, the faster it smells. And at its top level, it smelts one item every second. And you kind of just drop them on the top. And I can use a dropping system, drop them items here, and then automatically export it. I think you can actually export through this. But we're not going to worry about that right now. I just want to kind of see it in action. So let's give it some juice and see what happens. Oh, I always want to do the where it's shooting from first. And turn that on. There we go. Look at that. Look at it. Look at it. Beautiful. Beautiful. And it'll heat up. And over time, it will do its stuff. Let's grab some of this. I want to see if it can actually work on this stuff. And maybe set up the extraction just to verify that it works. Let's just do that. There we go. And it should start turning ingots. I guess an item pump here. Item pipe. Bestie. And a lever. That should take care of it. And let's see. And we do. We got draconium coming through. It's coming through pretty slow now, but I'm going to let this fire up for a while and see what it does. So what else do we want to get to here? Next will be the cinder plinth, I guess. We'll do the cinder plinth, so we're going to need a bin. And I'm just going to let that thing smelt up, and then we can see how fast it actually gets at some point. Because it should be getting faster. It's going really slow right now. Heat up. Cinder plinth. So we'll throw this here and there. Cinder plinth basically burns materials. I think it can burn almost any material and creates ash, which is from the mod. I think it's called ash. Let's go here. Embers, it creates, where is it? There it is. Ash piles. It creates this, which is used to do, what is that? A stamping recipe? I just want the recipe for the ash pile. Well, I guess it doesn't have a recipe. It has uses. A flat stamp? I don't even know what a flat stamp's for. Flat stamp. Flat stamp. It doesn't tell you. Not sure what a flat stamp's for. I haven't used one of those. We are going to use the... I've only used the plate and ingot. I might have to see what a flat stamp does. But anyway, I'm just babbling now. Let's do this. Let's set this up. Get that going. Getting this here. Oh, this way. And I should probably turn that on. So we'll hit this wall. And that'll start firing in there, powering that up. And basically, all we have to do now... I had cobble in here, didn't I? Heck, let's burn lead. No, I got cobble right here. Let's do this. Just take that, and you can just kind of right-click on there. You can use a dropper, you can pipe it in with an item pump, anything you want to do. And it should export it down here. Let's get an item gauge, just so we can see that. I want an item gauge for that, too. Let's get a couple more accessories. And anything else? No. Grab this, gonna throw that there. Slot, there's nothing in there yet? Oh, that's not working. What is the... Oh, I know why that's not working. I'm powering a bin right now. One thing you're working when working with this mod, you don't need to power bins, so don't try. I'm just a derp. And we should start seeing, yeah, seeing particle effects. And items should start coming down there. Yes, we got ash piles in there. And this ash pile is actually used in the alchemy setup for this mod. So it is pretty cool. It still hasn't got through that. It's gone through 20. I'm going to let that run pretty much the whole episode and see how it goes. Because it is supposed to get to about 60 a minute. But we'll see. Here. Oh, whoa, whoa, whoa. What am I doing? I'm hitting things. But yeah, these ash piles are used to make, well... One is the ashen, say the ashen armor, this ashen fabric. And the alchemy in this is a little odd. It's a little odd because the recipe is slightly different for everyone. And we'll get to that at that point. But say we're this down here, it says 12 to 24. It means there's a range for the amount of ash it needs that's in between 12 and 24. And it's random and it's different for every player, which is really odd concept. And I don't know why he went that way. It's just kind of an annoyance. But before we get on the alchemy, I'm going to let this build up. We're going to need a fair amount of that ash anyway. So let's grab some more cobble. I'll probably just use a hopper right now. Do I have any? No. Have I mentioned yet how much I love this mod? I just keep thinking about it. I'm like, oh, I love this thing. I love this. I'd love to have this in like a low-tech mod pack. Low-tech pack? Be amazing. Or like I said, a magic pack. This would go alongside a magic pack beautifully. And that'll just do that. Not take care of our needs there. What is this? Oh, ash was getting thrown out because there was too much in there. Should throw that in there. And one more time, check that. Oh, it's speeding up now. Speeding up now. So here we go. We got a copper cell and a charger. And this get direct. I have to check this actually. I don't know if this can power from that or not. We'll see. We'll see if it can power directly from the battery or not. It should be able to. I would think it would. So we're going to put a receptor on this. And then we're going to get into some of the actual, you know, weapons and stuff in this, which is going to be kind of cool. That's going. I need another connection. This might be too far, but we'll try. We'll see if this works. Oh, not there first. There. To here. Hit that. Can it make it? Yes, it can. Look at that. Look at it. Magical. Magical. And that should be getting ember. I don't know if this has an ember gauge on it or not. It does. And that is not getting ember. So that tells me what I need to know there. No point having it on a battery. And the whole purpose of this is to charge. Where are they? I did make some already. The batteries. There they are. The mantle jars. There are two kinds of these jars. One, it can sit in your inventory. This one can sit in your inventory. Let's go to embers. One can sit in your inventory. This one can sit in your offhand. I don't like the idea of that, so I'm not going to use these ones. I'm going to use the ones that sit in your inventory. But we can just take these. Go here. And it's charging. That'll charge it. Wait till it gets full charge. And it'll be good to go. It's still charging. While that's doing that, let's make a couple of items here. We're going to make some of the tools. So, because that's what these batteries are for. Let's start with the sinter shaft. Do we have everything? Oh, we don't have silver plates. I'd never taught it to make silver plates. Okay, I gotta go teach it to make silver plates. Okay, taught it to make silver plates. It's good to go. Gonna throw some more draconium over there. Get a good idea how good it's working now. I'm just gonna throw a massive amount and see how it goes. We'll just do this. Hold shift. No, hold shift. Ah, no. There we go. Hold shift. There we go. And I'll cook it all at once. Curious. What? Where? Did you guys just... Why is that glitching out? It's like trying to put items back into the pipe. I am very confused right now. Turn it off. What happens? Nothing. It is like cooking 1 a second. Oh, it's just... This pack has... It's good, but it has visual glitches. Like, it's giving me errors. So I'm going to stop trying to sort that because it's giving me errors. But yeah, it's sorting fast. It is going about 1 a second because you can see it. 1 1000, 1 1000. But yeah, getting some kind of visual glitch there. Don't know what's going on. Not going to worry about that right now. Actually, let's make the laser first. And just as I say that, we need dawnstone plates. Oh no, I already made some. There we go. Sweet. And that, there we go. And clockwork axe, do I have everything? Maybe, yes. And clockwork pick. What did I need on the pick? Just an ember shard, this. And all these have special little secondaries. This is probably my favorite right here, grand hammer. Dawstone. Go, let's do that. There we go. How many was it? Was it just two? Was it two? Two? Yes, it was two. Excellent. Throw those in there. Go here. Go there. Go here. Make the dawnstone plates. I forgot that I made about a stack of them. It's the same exact same setup as the ingots, except for you use a plate stamp. So the plate stamp is just right here. Plate. Doom. It's just where you put the camonite blend. It's just a different shape. So it goes in the corners, makes the raw plate, smelt it. And then, yeah, instead of putting the ingot plate there, put that one there. Cooks down some dawstone. You're good to go. I forgot to tell you guys, too. Half of this is glowstone. Half of it isn't. So I've got tons of glowstone. I got painted glowstone. I got more over here. Painted walls. Painted cobblestone. It's all cobblestone. This is all cobblestone. Except for some of it. That's real. You can tell by the texture slightly. These batteries, they just have to be in your inventory when you're using these tools. They power the tools. And all these tools have secondary effects and primary effects. This one here, it is just what it is. It's a blazing laser ray. Oop, poor sheep. Pew. It's pretty accurate. Pretty accurate too. So that's that one. And it doesn't use much. Three shots. I guess it was 25 a blast. The axe, well, if you right click with it. Oh, I did it too fast. Oh, I thought it did a big giant AoE. I'm pretty sure this does. Oh, this is the axe. I need a tree. What am I doing? Let's go here. Here's a tree. There we go. It just breaks a tree. Doesn't do it all, but it does a giant heck of it. Giant piece of it. And it has a cooldown, so that is the thing. The clockwork pickaxe. Pretty cool. Let's go destroy some area here. Clockwork pickaxe. It digs a 3x2. Pretty cool. And it has a cooldown as well. So, pretty cool as well. I don't want a hole here, so I'm going to fill it back in. Because just knowing that I did this in the past and flying by would drive me nuts. And there we go. Next would be this one. I really like this one. This one's pretty cool. So, we got a poor little sheep down there. We're going to hold, right click, and just fire. Boom. Yeah. Big giant ball of destruction. Boom. There we go. And you can shoot smaller ones too, but these small ones, they do barely any hit. And you can, you know, do different sizes. So, that's pretty cool. And, you know, it does drain the jars pretty quick, but not super quick. And this last one here, where are those cows that I saw? We'll go over here, see the cows, and this one is just a big giant battle weapon, so yeah, the cow goes flying, and this will AoE, so if there was like, you know, 6-7 mobs here, and I hit this, it would take almost all of them out, and wouldn't have to worry about it. This is actually a really good weapon too, actually. It has 11 attack damage, so not bad at all. Pretty cool weapon. These are pretty cool. I really like the look of them too, because if you actually look at these, look at the size of that. Like, you got your gun, you got your axe. The axe looks pretty awesome too. The pick, big hunk of metal off the side of it. You got your wand. Like, I just love the look of this mod. Okay, I'm gonna have to end this video here. It is going really long, longer than I expected. I'm trying to get my video times back down normal. Last one was pretty long, but I'm gonna end this here. So. In between episodes, I'm going to clean this all up. I'm going to get alchemy all set up and ready to go, and we'll move forward from there. Should only take a couple minutes, and then we can move on to something else. And then, yeah, we'll move on to different things. But as always, if you like this video, hit that like button. If you really liked it, hit that subscribe button. It's much appreciated. And I will see you guys in the next video. I want you all to have a good one, and later.